Hi, Swaros.
Hello, Swaro.
Good afternoon, my dear friends.
Good afternoon, friend.
Myself, T.Mayuri from 7th grade. I'm from Siputi Girls. And these all are my friends. Now they will introduce themselves.
Hi, friends. I am Maheshwari Swaro.
Hi, friends. This is Pregnanidhi Swaro.
Hi, friends. Myself, Pravalika Swaro.
Hi, friends. This is Anusha Swaro.
I invite you all today to my presentation on nutrition in plants. So, before we go further, I would like to ask few questions. I hope that everyone had your lunch before coming here, didn't you?
Yes.
Can I ask what items you had for your lunch?
Yes.
I had an egg.
Good. Do you know from where we get egg?
Yes, we get eggs from hens.
What else you had for your lunch?
I had curd.
Good. Do you know from where we get curd?
Yes, we get curd from milk and we get milk from cows and buffaloes.
What else you had for your lunch?
I had banana.
I had rice.
Good. Do you know from where we get bananas and rice?
Yes, we get them from plants and trees.
Good. Yes. By your answers, can I summarize that we get food from animals, birds and plants?
Yes.
Out of three sources, by which source we get maximum and many varieties of food items?
From plants.
Can you name few other food items we get from plants?
Yes, we get fruits like apple, banana, guava, etc. And we get cereals like rice, red gram, black gram, green gram, etc. And we get dry fruits like kismis, cashew nuts, etc.
Okay. This means our major source of food is plants, isn't it?
Yes.
Do you know, friends, what is this?
Yes, this is rice.
Yes, you are exactly correct. It is rice. Then which component does a rice contain?
Carbohydrates.
Yes, you are exactly correct. Rice contains carbohydrates. Then how the carbohydrates help us?
Carbohydrates gives us energy.
Yes, you are exactly correct. Carbohydrates gives us energy. Then what is this, Swaros?
Green gram.
Yes, you are exactly correct. It is green gram. Then which component does a green gram contain?
Proteins.
Yes, you are exactly correct. Green gram contains proteins. Then how the proteins are going to help us?
Proteins help us in our body growth and development.
You are exactly correct, Swaros. Proteins help us in body growth and development. Then what is this, Swaros?
Apple.
Yes, you are exactly correct. It is apple. Then which component does an apple contain?
Vitamins.
Yes, you are absolutely correct. Apple contains vitamins. Then how the vitamins are going to help us?
Vitamins keep us healthy.
You are exactly and absolutely right answer, Swaros. Vitamins keep us healthy. So, these all are called as balanced diet. So, if we eat the balanced diet, we can be healthy and we get this balanced diet from the plants. Isn't it, Swaros?
Yes.
So, by this, now let us enter into our topic. So, today our topic is nutrition in plants. What is our topic, Swaros?
Nutrition in plants.
Yes, nutrition in plants. Then, do you know, Swaros, what is nutrition?
Yes, nutrition means the process in which an organism takes in food and assimilates it is called nutrition.
Yes, you are absolutely correct. Nutrition means the process an organism which takes in food and assimilates it is called as nutrition. Do you know, friends, till 350 years ago, people believed that plant can produce everything what they absorb from the soil. Now, let us go to a picture, Swaros. Who is this, Swaros?
He is John Baptista von Helmut.
Yes, you are exactly correct. He is John Baptista von Helmut. Then, by doing the experiment, what did he conclude?
John Baptista von Helmut, through his experiments, he demonstrated that the substances required for the growth of a plant do not come only from the soil.
And plants grow because the water it gets.
Yes, you are absolutely correct. Von Helmut, by doing the experiments, he concluded that the substances required for the growth of a plant do not come from the soil only. The plant grow because of the water it gets. Do you know, friends, how Von Helmut proved that? Let us come to know how he proved that only soil is not necessary for a growth of a plant. So, first of all, he chose a plant and dry soil. After that, he planted the plant in a pot and he covered the plant with a lid. So, the lid has holes because the air and water have to reach to the roots of the plants. So, and he had to give only rain water because the rain water is fresh water. So, this experiment continued for 5 years. So, after 5 years, the results are as follows. So, Swaros, now let us go to a slide.
Yes.
So, Swaros, in this case, if it disappear in one form, it should be appear in another form. So, when he measured the mass of a tree at start, it was 2.27 and after 5 years, it was 76.74. So, change in mass is 74.47 and dry soil at start, it was 90.72. After 5 years, it was 90.66 and change in mass is 0.06. Here, the dry soil has disappeared and whatever the disappeared soil, whatever the disappeared mass, the tree has absorbed from the dry soil. But the tree has absorbed only 0.06 mass. Then remaining mass from where the tree has absorbed, Swaros?
From surroundings.
Yes, you are exactly correct. The tree absorbed from the surroundings. So, by this experiment, Jan Baptista Warm Helmet, he proved that the substances required for the growth of a plant do not come from the soil only. The plant grow because of the water it gets. So, it is an eye open for all the people. Did you clear, Swaros?
Yes.
Now, let us go to another slide. Observe the picture, Swaros. Who is he?
He is Stephen Hales.
Yes, you are exactly correct. He is Stephen Hales. Then, what did he describe?
Stephen Hales described that plants lose excess water through their leaves. This is known as transpiration.
And plants exchange gases from the surroundings.
Yes, you are exactly correct. Stephen Hales described that plant lose excess water through their root, through their leaves. So, it is known as transpiration. And plants exchange the gases from the surrounding air. So, this is described by Stephen Hales. Did you clear it, Swaros?
Yes.
Now, let us go to another picture. Who is this, Swaros?
He is Presley.
Yes, you are exactly correct. He is Presley. Then, what did he demonstrate it?
Presley demonstrated that while animals are making the air impure, the plants are making the air pure.
Yes, you are absolutely correct, friend. Presley demonstrated that while animals are making the air impure and plants are making the air pure. So, it is then demonstrated by Presley. And let us go to another picture. Who is this, Swaros?
He is engine hose.
Yes, you are absolutely correct, friend. He is engine hose. So, engine hose proved that only green parts of the plants when exposed to sunlight only can purify the impure air. And many other scientists through their experiments brought many facts to light. Did you clear, Swaros?
Yes.
Swaros, do you know that what is photosynthesis?
Yes. Green parts of the plant absorb carbon dioxide from surrounding air. And in the presence of sunlight, they make glucose, starch and other food materials with water. This phenomenon is called photosynthesis.
In the process of photosynthesis, plants leave out oxygen. Thus, plants purify the impure air.
Yes, you are absolutely correct, friend. Photosynthesis means green parts of the plants absorb carbon dioxide from the surrounding air. In the presence of sunlight, they make glucose, starch and other food material with water. So, this phenomenon is known as photosynthesis. What is this?
Photosynthesis.
Yes, you are absolutely correct, friends. It is a photosynthesis. And in the process of photosynthesis, plants leave out oxygen and thus plants purify the impure air. Did you clear, Swaros?
Yes.
And do you know, friends? Photosynthesis have 4 factors. How many factors?
4 factors.
Yes, 4 factors. Then what are they?
Sunlight,
chlorophyll,
water,
carbon dioxide.
Yes, you are absolutely correct. Sunlight, chlorophyll, carbon dioxide and water. So, by these 4 factors, photosynthesis is going to prepare its own food. Did you clear it, Swaros?
Yes.
Now, let us come to know how plants get water. Do you know, Swaros, how plants get water?
Yes, plants get water from the soil by their roots. This water reaches to the leaves through the stem.
Yes, you are absolutely correct. Plants get water from soil through their roots and this water reaches to the leaves by the help of stem. So, friends, now let us look in picture. So, Swaros, observe the picture. What do you find?
A person is sprinkling fertilizers.
Yes, you are absolutely correct. A person is sprinkling the fertilizers.
Then why he is sprinkling fertilizers?
Wow, it's a good question. I can clarify your doubt, Swaros. So, Swaros, whenever a leaves of a rice or wheat turn into yellow, farmers sprinkle urea. So, this urea dissolves in water and the water reaches to the leaves by the help of roots and stem. So, because of this purpose, farmers sprinkle urea. And if the water reaches to the leaves again it turn into green color. So, by this purpose, farmers sprinkle urea. Did you clear, Swaros?
Yes.
Now, let us know importance of sunlight. So, Swaros, now let us do an experiment to find that if sunlight is essential for photosynthesis. So, required materials are plant, black leaves, black strip and iodine solution. For procedure is, first of all, take a plant and plant it in a pot. So, keep this pot in a dark place for 4 to 5 days. After then, take the pot and keep it in a sunlight. And cover the half middle portion of the leaf with a black paper. So, after few hours, take the paper and remove the paper and dip the leaf in a iodine solution. Then the results are the portion which is covered with black paper do not turn into blue or black color. The portion which is not covered with black paper it turn into blue or black color because the portion which is covered with black paper, the sunlight did not fall. And the portion which is not covered with black paper, it gets the sunlight. So, by this we can say that sunlight is most essential for photosynthesis. Did you clear, Swaros?
Yes.
Now, let us know what does a leaf contains.
A leaf contains two major substances, they are chlorophyll and stomata.
Yes, you are exactly correct. A leaf contains two major substances, they are chlorophyll and stomata. Then Swaros, how the plants are going to exchange the gases?
By the help of stomata.
Yes, the plant is going to exchange the gases by the help of stomata.
Do you know one thing, friends? Human beings use nose to exchange gases and plants use stomata to exchange gases. So, stomata acts like nose of the plant.
Yes, you are exactly correct, Swaros. Stomata acts as a nose of the plant. So, by the help of stomata, plants are going to exchange the gases. Did you clear it, Swaros?
Yes.
And plants have two other parts. They exchange the gases by these two other parts. They are known as loose tissues and lenticels. Did you clear it, Swaros?
Yes.
Now, let us go to how do plants produce only starch?
No, plants can also produce many other food materials like proteins, fats as well as starch.
Yes, you are exactly correct, Swaros. Plants not only produce starch, they can produce many other things like proteins and fats. Then can you give the examples of proteins?
Yes, examples like proteins are green gram, black gram, Bengal gram, red gram, etc. and peas, beans.
Yes, you are exactly correct. Examples of proteins are green gram, peas, red gram, black gram, etc. And friends, do you tell the examples of fats?
Yes, examples of fats are coconut, sesame, groundnuts, etc.
Yes, you are absolutely correct, Swaros. Examples of fats are groundnuts, coconuts, sesame, etc. are the examples of fats. So, Swaros, now let us do an activity to find that how many main nutrients does a plant require. So, friends, now I will give you each one of you for one flashcard. So, by using the flashcard, you have to answer for my questions. Are you ready?
Yes!
Did you got your flashcards, Swaros?
Yes!
Then can I ask first question?
Yes!
So, Swaros, first question is, how many main nutrients does a plant require?
3 nutrients.
Yes, you are absolutely correct. The plant requires 3 nutrients. Then what are they?
Nitrogen,
phosphorus,
potassium.
Yes, they are nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. Then how they are denoted?
Nitrogen is denoted by capital N.
Phosphorus is denoted by capital P.
Potassium is denoted by capital K.
Yes, you are absolutely correct. Nitrogen is denoted by capital N. Phosphorus is denoted by capital P. And potassium is denoted by capital K. And they are popularly known as NPK fertilizers. What are they, Swaros?
NPK fertilizers.
NPK fertilizers. And a part of nutrient above plant requires small quantity of nutrients. So, these nutrients are called micronutrients. What we call, Swaros?
Micronutrients.
Yes, micronutrients. And plants absorb these nutrients from the soil. Did you clear it, Swaros?
Yes.
Now, friends, to enjoy ourselves, now let us sing a song. Are you ready?
Yes. Plant a plant for health, plant a plant for love, plant a plant that grows all the way around the world. Plant a plant for health, plant a plant for love, plant a plant that grows all the way around the world. Plant a plant for me, plant a plant for you, that the wish for my health will one day come true. Plant a plant for me, plant a plant for you, that the wish for our health will one day come true. Seeing green around the world, seeing green around the world, seeing green around the world. Plant a plant for planet, plant a plant to breathe, plant a plant the stretched all the way around the world. Plant a plant for planet, plant a plant to breathe, plant a plant the stretched all the way around the world. Plant a plant for rains, plant a plant to survive, plant a plant that purify the impure air. Plant a plant for rains, plant a plant to survive, plant a plant that purify the impure air. Seeing good around the world, seeing good around the world, seeing good around the world. Plant a plant for health, plant a plant for love, plant a plant that grow all over on the world. Plant a plant for me, plant a plant for you, that the wish for our health will one day come true. Seeing health around the world, seeing health around the world, seeing health around the world. Plant a plant for planet, plant a plant to breathe, plant a plant that spreads shed all over around the world. Plant a plant for rains, plant a plant to survive, plant a plant that purify the impure air. Seeing good around the world, Plant a plant and grow all over around the world. Plant a plant for me, plant a plant for you. That the wish for world health will one day come true. Seeing green around the world. Seeing green around the world. Seeing green around the world. Plant a plant for planet, plant a plant to breathe. Plant a plant that spreads shed all away around the world. Plant a plant for friends, plant a plant to serve. Plant a plant that purifies the impure air. Seeing good around the world. Seeing good around the world. Seeing good around the world.
Wow, what an energetic performance! Did you enjoy yourself, sparrows?
Yes!
Now, let us enter into classification of plants. Do you know, sparrows, how many types of nutrition are there?
Yes, two types.
Yes, you are exactly correct. There are two types of nutrition. Then what are they?
Autotrophic nutrition,
heterotrophic nutrition.
Yes, you are exactly correct. There are autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. The sparrows, do you know what is autotrophic nutrition?
Plants which prepare food on their own and live on their own are called autotrophs.
Yes, you are absolutely correct, Maheshwari. Autotrophic nutrition means the plants which prepare their own food and live on their own is known as autotrophic nutrition. So, example, all green plants come under the autotrophic nutrition. Then friends, now let us learn what is heterotrophic nutrition. So, heterotrophic nutrition means most plants on our earth are green, but certain plants do not contain chlorophyll in their leaves or some other parts. So, these plants are called non-green plants and they cannot manufacture their own food. So, these are called heterotrophic nutrition. Did you clear, sparrows?
Yes!
Now, let us come to know how many types are there in heterotrophic nutrition. Do you know, sparrows, how many types are there?
Yes, four types.
Yes, you are absolutely correct. There are four types in heterotrophic nutrition. Then can you tell me?
Parasitic plants,
saprophytic plants,
insectivorous plants,
symbiotic plants.
Yes, you are absolutely correct. There are parasitic plants, saprophytic plants, insectivorous plants and symbiotic plants. Then can you tell what is parasitic plants, Varos?
Yes, parasitic plants neither have leaves nor chlorophyll. They can't produce their own food. They are thread-like and seen twining around the plants of autotroph. They get their food from the autotrophic plants. Example, cascata.
Yes, you are absolutely correct. Parasitic plants means they cannot manufacture their own food and depend on autotroph. So, these are called parasitic plants. So, example, cascata. So, friends, now let us go and picture. Observe the pictures, Varos. Were you fine?
A thread-like structure is twining around the autotrophic nutrition.
Yes, you are absolutely correct. A thread-like structure is twining around the autotroph plants.
I think so. It is cascata.
Yes, you are exactly correct, Pragna. It is a cascata. So, it is the example of parasitic plants. Did you clear, Swaros?
Yes.
Now, let us know what is saprophytic plants. Do you know, Swaros, what is saprophytic plants?
Yes. Saprophytic plants grow on dead and decaying matter. Example, fungal growth on bread, coconut, cake and pickles.
Yes, you are absolutely correct. Saprophytic plants means they grow on dead and decaying matter is known as saprophytic plant. So, in example, fungal growth on bread, cakes, pickles and coconut. So, friends, now let us have a picture. What do you find in pictures, Varos?
It is fungal growth.
Okay. Stop your debate. I can clarify your doubt. So, friends, if the fungi is grown on bread, we call it as a fungus. And if the fungal is grown on bread, we call it as also bread mold. So, according to you, the answer is also correct. And according to you, the answer is also correct. Did you clear, sparrows?
Yes.
Now, let us know what is Insectivorous plants. Do you know, Swaros, what is insectivorous plants?
Yes, insectivorous plants prepare their food and also get from insects. Their leaves are specially modified to trap insects. They grow in areas where nitrogen is deficient. Example, Groceras, Urticularia and Venus flytrap, etc.
Yes, you are absolutely correct. Insectivorous plants means they prepare their own food and also depend on insects, and their leaves are specially modified to trap insects, and they live in areas where nitrogen is deficient. So, Swaros, now let us go to picture. Observe the picture, Swaros. What do you find?
Nepenthes.
Yes, these are the Nepenthes. And observe the second picture. What do you find?
Insects.
Yes, the leaf is trapping the insect. So, the leaves are specially modified to trap insect. So, these are called an insectivorous plants. Did you clear it, Swaros?
Yes.
Now, let us go to an symbiotic plants. Do you know, Swaros, what is symbiotic plants?
Yes, symbiotic plants means the organisms which live together and share their food and shelter equally. They are called symbiotic plants.
Yes, you are absolutely correct. Symbiotic plants means the organism which share their food and shelter equally is called an symbiotic plant. So, example, rhizobium bacteria.
Friend, then what are the benefits of symbiosis relationship?
Wow, it's a good question. I can clarify your doubt. See, Swaros, the plant benefits because it gains nitrogen from the bacteria, and the bacteria it benefits nitrogen and nutrient and sugars to survive. So, this bacteria benefits from plant and the plant benefits from bacteria. So, these are the benefits of rhizobium bacteria. Did you clear, Swaros?
Yes.
Now, let us have a picture. So, observe the picture, Swaros. Here, the bacteria and plants, they are sharing their food and shelter equally. So, this is the example of symbiotic plants. Then, Swaros, do you know what are the uses of plants?
Yes.
Can you tell me?
Plants gives us oxygen.
Plants give us food.
Plants gives us rains.
Plants give us medicines.
Yes. Plants give us shade.
Plants gives us shelter.
Plants give us many food materials and furnitures also.
Yes, you are exactly correct. By plants, we are getting many benefits. So, if the plants are not there on earth, we will also not live on earth. Isn't it, Swaros?
Yes.
So, today our motto is plant a plant to save the earth. Then what are your mottos?
My motto is save the plants and save the nation.
And my motto is green India, clean India.
My motto is save the plants. It is guarantee for your future.
My motto is save the plant. It will save you.
So friends, I think you understood my class. Didn't you?
Yes.
So then can you tell me what you understand from my class?
Okay. By today's class, we learned that we human beings get food from animals, plants and birds.
Majority of our food come from plants and trees.
Through trees, we get many things. Like fruits, vegetables, cereals, nuts, etc.
All these materials are required to get a balanced diet for us.
Trees and plants are our great friends. Without them, we cannot survive.
Plants take away the poisonous carbon dioxide in the atmosphere and leave out the important requirement of our life, that is oxygen.
It is believed for a long time that plants can produce everything from what they absorb from the soil.
Mr. Hellman proved that plants grow because water it gets.
Plants exchange the gases from surroundings.
Presley proved that animals are making the air impure and plants are making the air pure.
Ingenhouse proved that when green parts of the plants exposed to sunlight only can purify the impure air.
Plants take away the carbon from carbon dioxide. They take hydrogen and oxygen from water, which they absorb through their roots from soil.
Plants produce glucose combining oxygen, carbon and hydrogen in the presence of sunlight with the help of chlorophyll. This process is called photosynthesis.
In the absence of any of four, that is water, air, sunlight and chlorophyll, plants do not produce their food.
Leaves of plants get water from soil through roots and stem.
Plants exchange gases through minute holes called stomata.
Plants not only produce starch
but also proteins and fats. Proteins like peas, beans, grams, etc. and fats like groundnut, coconut, etc.
There are mainly three nutrients there: nitrogen, phosphorus and potassium. Nitrogen is denoted by capital N, phosphorus is denoted by capital P, potassium is denoted by capital K.
Apart from NPK fertilizers, plants also need some nutrients in small quantities. Those are called micronutrients.
Plants absorb these nutrients from soil.
Plants are classified into two categories. They are autotrophs and heterotrophs.
The plants which prepare food on their own and live on their own are called autotrophs. Example, all green plants.
The plants which cannot feed on their own and depend on autotrophs and insects for survival are called heterotrophic plants. Example, cuscuta.
Heterotrophic nutrition is classified into four types. They are parasitic plants, saprophytic plants, insectivorous plants and symbiotic plants.
Parasitic plants neither have leaves nor chlorophyll. They can't produce their own food. They are thread-like and seen twining around the plants of autotroph. They get their food from the stem of the autotrophic plant. Example, cuscuta.
Saprophytic plants grow on dead and decaying matter. Example, fungal growth on bread, cake, coconut and pickles, etc.
Insectivorous plants prepare their food and also get from insects. Their leaves are specially modified to wrap insects. They grow in areas where nitrogen is deficient. Example, Roseras, Urticularia and Venus flytrap, etc.
Symbiotic plants means the organisms which live together and share their food and shelter equally. They are called symbiotic plants.
Thank you, my dear friends. I hope that everyone understood my class, isn't it?
Yes!
So, friends, thank you to everyone and my heartfelt thanks to Dr. R.S. Praveen Kumar sir who introduced this program and my heartfelt thanks to my principal ma'am, Bhagya ma'am and my heartfelt thanks to my all teachers and especially guidance teachers are Radha Mohan sir, Navin sir, Sandhya ma'am, Shafil sir and Swapna ma'am. Thank you to everyone. Bye.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye.